Laura, I know that you love to cook, and I actually just really quickly want to ask you a question, because I was saying it's not Prepon Kitchen, it's right. Prepon Kitchen. Can you yes. tell me the history of why that is the name?
Well, it's Prepon Kitchen because I feel like if you prep your food in advance, it's a lot easier to get homemade meals on the table. And also, for years, people have always called me Laura Prepon. So it's kind of like this beautiful mix of, you know, it helping you prep quickly and also people messing up my name.
I love that. All right, we want to bring someone who is a dear friend to the show. She is going to teach us a recipe because, listen, we're talking about Mother's Day week. And I mean, this woman is a mom and a grandmother, and we all fell in love with her as Brunch with Babs on TikTok, and her videos are deliciously addicting to watch. So please welcome back Babs! Babs!
So happy to be here again.
So Babs, I want you to tell us and teach us a perfect Mother's Day brunch type of recipe. What is this?
Okay, so this is a lovely frittata we're going to be making this today. And frittatas have like an emotional connection with me because my earliest memory of my mom in the kitchen, coming from a first generation Italian family, was making potatoes and eggs on a Friday. And we call them frittatas. So frittatas have come a long way.
Yeah.
And for Mother's Day, as again, so versatile, you can use the vegetables your mom loves or the protein or whatever. But today, we're making a bacon Gruyere veggie frittata.
Okay, Babs.
So, yeah, and really great combination,
right? And we're cooking it all with Laura's beautiful Prepon kitchenware, which I'm so excited to feature. So we're your students, and we want you to teach us, Babs.
Okay.
Walk us through it.
All right, so here's what, so far I think we fried 5 strips of bacon, and we set that aside, and we crumbled that. And we reserved 2 tablespoons of the bacon fat. And we blistered tomatoes, about a cup of cherry tomatoes. And to that, we added leeks and shiitake mushrooms. And now, girls, you're going to add to your skillet a cup of fresh baby spinach.
Oh, beautiful.
Gonna add that. And to that, you're going to add a tablespoon of fresh thyme, which is ready
Ooh,
to go.
I love fresh herbs.
Yes.
As my mom says, fresh herbs makes everything fancy.
Amen, yes.
It does.
And then you're also gonna return the crumbled bacon, the cooked bacon, back to your skillet.
Yes, please.
Okay.
So now we're gonna just drizzle it with just a little olive oil, just over the top, so that when we make our frittata, it's gonna come sliding right out, because eventually that's gonna come out of the skillet.
Yeah, so, skillets also, it's blue carbon steel, so the more you use it, it becomes more naturally nonstick.
Oh, lovely.
So it's great for this frittata. Yeah.
I have to say, too, one thing that I really now have come to care about in pots and pans is how easy and amazing it is that this is a very hot pan and yet I can grab the sides.
Right.
Well done. Thank you
Thank
for that.
Thank you.
Okay, now what?
So now we're going to focus on the egg mixture. So I think you have like, I know you have 10 eggs already in there. You're going to crack 2 more. It's a 12-egg frittata.
And Drew, toss your shells in the bag. It's for food scraps.
By the way, Laura, please show us this because I'm obsessed.
No, sorry, Babs. Did not mean to interrupt. I just want to make sure Drew throws her little food scraps in the bag because this is also to help with making your food prep easier. All your food scraps just toss right into your bag.
That's brilliant.
And then later,
that's fabulous.
This is biodegradable and compostable.
Oh, my word.
Get rid of it.
Yep. Perfect.
I don't mean to be hyperbolic, but I never want to see a cutting board again without this. I'm sorry. Ever. I'm going to
Thanks,
be using
Drew.
This cutting board from now on.
Oh,
Thank
it is.
You.
With the automatic garbage.
Oh, God. Bag. What am I doing next?
So
now
continue.
We're putting
sorry.
In a quarter cup of, you can use heavy cream, you can use half and half or full fat milk, and that's going right into the eggs.
Okay.
And then a half a teaspoon of salt and a half a teaspoon of pepper. Yeah, you can start whisking. All right. And just mix that whole thing. And then we're gonna add the 3/4 cup of cheese to our egg mixture.
Great.
And you don't need to make the eggs frothy. Just till everything
Great.
Is kind of combined. Don't overdo it.
I overdo everything, Bab. I do.
Every moderation is hard.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm working
moderation.
Out and my trainer, Katrina, will be like, stop. Like, and I'm just like, I'm like a jackrabbit. That's not
how I need to be more like that.
Moderation is a delicate balance, you know.
I think I'm just a little intense.
And then we're going to pour that over our veggie bacon mixture.
Ooh.
So we're just gonna pour that on and we're gonna let it set for a few seconds until eventually we see a crust forming around the edge of the skillet, mm-hmm. you know, where the eggs meet the skillet. And when you see that, you're just gonna push the egg mixture into the center, mm-hmm. much like you're making curds, like scrambled eggs. So I think now we could put it in the oven at 450 for 5 minutes. And then after
Ready?
5 minutes, mm-hmm. at 450, in they go.
Thank you.
Then we're gonna take them out and put them on your platter or your whatever, and you can serve them. And don't they look yummy?
They look so beautiful.
Should we try it?
This is so good. Mm.
It is delicious.
This is amazing.
You guys did an amazing job.
This is incredible.
Babs.
This is great.
I can't imagine having any Mother's Day celebration without you. May we please keep celebrating what it's like to be a mom, a woman, you know.
A grandma.
A human.
A human.
And Laura, I am just so thrilled to do this with you. I'm so excited about Prepon Kitchen. I'm so thrilled. And be sure to check out Laura's culinary line, Prepon Kitchen, launching on HSN May 7th. And Babs, thank you.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day. Thank you for having me.